Recently, I've been playing around with some different ways of constructing Tokyo futures. The example task that I'm trying to complete in all these cases is counting the number of lines in a file. At the end of the day, what I want is a future that I can spawn as a task and use map to print out the number of lines. In the previous video, I had a library function that used a callback instead of futures, so I showed a couple of ways that this count lines function could be brought into Tokyo when used as a future. The first example was this one, a leaf future, and the distinguishing feature of that is I needed to record a reference to the currently running task and notify it when I'm ready for another poll. After that, I showed how you could use a one-shot channel to essentially turn any callback into a future. This little blob is not very clean or self-contained, but it's quick and easy to write. It does the job. I said that in the next video I would count the lines using Tokyo's I/O functionality instead, so I'm going to do that in two different ways. Obviously, to count lines we have to read file data from disk, which is relatively slow. The basic idea I'm using is that instead of having a dedicated thread that sits there twiddling its thumbs until the operating system delivers each chunk of data, maybe we could represent that relatively slow read by some sort of inner async future that operates in the background. Then when that future completes, our outer future gets scheduled to do the counting work using the data that's been read. So let's have a look at the first example. In this one, I'm trying to write as little code as possible by taking advantage of the functionality already present in the Tokyo and Futures libraries. All the work happens in this count task part in the middle. First, I open a file. This is a Tokyo file struct, so calling this doesn't actually open a file. It returns a future that will resolve to an open file when it's polled. Now I use an and then combinator to receive that open file if when it is open and do something with it. I add support for buffered reading by wrapping it inside a buff reader. This isn't specific to Tokyo, it's part of the Rust standard library. Then I can give this to the Tokyo lines function. Let's have a quick look at the docs for that. This is a free function, it doesn't take a self parameter. I can pass it something that implements async read and buff read. Our buff reader will do the job nicely, and it returns a stream of lines. So let's have a closer look at that stream. This is the lines object. Okay, impulse stream for lines, type item equals string. This means that it will emit a series of strings where each string contains one line. I don't actually want a stream of strings, I don't really care what the lines contain, I just want to count how many things get emitted. So this is one way I can do that. The fold function turns a stream into a future. You start with an accumulator value, which could be anything, in this case I'm saying it's a number, which is the number of lines counted, and it starts at zero. Then for each value that comes out of the stream, it runs a supplied function, which in this case is a closure. It passes in the current value of the accumulator and the new value that came from the string, which I'm just throwing away in this case because I don't want the string. I just want to add one to the accumulator. I'll return that as a successful future using the OK helper from the futures crate. So the fold function will sit there and keep processing values until the string runs out because we reach the end of the file. At this point, the fold future resolves with the final value of the accumulator. In this case, this will be the number of lines. So this entire count task is a future that will resolve to a use size on success or an IO error on failure, which means all we are left to do is print out the result. I'll do this as a release build. I have a 100 megabyte test file, which is called enwik8, which is somewhat famous because it's used for a compression competition. It has around a million lines, and I've put it in a RAND disk. So it's worked. Let's actually time it. So that's taking somewhere around 240 milliseconds to do it. Let's compare that with, say, the standard WC utility. Okay, that's much faster, only around 75 milliseconds. So my nice compact Tokyo code works, but it's several times slower than the state-of-the-art utility. You know, looking at the code again, I can make an educated guess as to one of the reasons that it's slow. Every single time a line is found, my closure gets invoked to increment the counter by one. That's a lot of trips back and forth for 1.1 million lines. So what if I reduce the number of round trips? Here I'm extracting exactly one line at a time and then add one to the counter. What if I did a bigger read, say up to 4 kilobytes of data, and counted all the lines in that chunk at once? Then we would only have this callback overhead for every 4 kilobytes instead of every line, assuming our lines are shorter than 4 kilobytes. Hopefully that's a sensible assumption. Doing this is a bit more complicated, so I'm going to implement it as a custom future that polls inner futures. The end result is going to be actually quite nice and self-contained. Our line counting future has two states, so I'm going to implement it as an enum. I've taken this technique from the official Tokyo guide, by the way, it's really quite nice. When our future is first created, it starts in the pending state. We haven't done anything yet, we haven't even opened the file. We have a future loaded up ready to give us a file, but it won't do anything until it's actually polled. The second state is when we're in the middle of counting. While we're in the process of counting, we have two pieces of associated data, the file that we're reading from and the number of lines that we've counted so far, which I'm storing as a usize. Eventually we'll finish counting, but we don't need to make a state for that because we'll just return the result. Once we return a value from poll, Tokyo will never poll us again. So now that we know the states, we can write the new function. We take the path to the file as a parameter and turn it into an open future that will eventually open a file at the path we specified. Not right now, only when we poll it. So that gets placed inside the pending state, and that's how we begin. Next, we need to implement future for this new type. The item that the future resolves to is the number of lines, so that's going to be a usize. I know that the Tokyo IO functions could return a Tokyo IO error, so if that happens, we'll make the future pass those on directly. Finally, we need an implementation of the poll function. Since we're relying on other futures, we need to follow an important rule. We may only return from poll if we have the final answer, or if we need a result from an inner future that's not ready yet. In that case, we should also return not ready. Now, if you look at this code, you'll notice that there's nowhere that ever returns not ready. And in fact, it's hidden behind this try ready macro. We're going to poll some inner future, which will return a poll result, which will feed into the try ready macro. So if it's ready, we'll simply take the value t and write the rest of our code as if it was always available, as if it's always going to be successful. However, there are two other cases that have to be handled. If the inner future is not ready, then we're going to return not ready as well. Our poll function will exit until it gets polled again in the future when the inner future is ready. If there's an error returned, then we'll propagate that error upward as well. To see how this actually works, imagine that we're polled for the very first time. We'll match ourselves to see what state we're in, and it will be pending, because that's how we set it up in new. It's now time to actually open the file by polling the open future. Sooner or later, open future will finish opening the file, and the open file will get placed into this binding file. We can now move into our second state, counting. We have our file and 0 lines counted so far. The match statement ends, and we reach the end of our poll function. But remember the rule, we don't have our final result yet, and we're not waiting on an inner future yet. This means we need to keep doing more work. So that's why there's an infinite loop around all this. So we go back to the start and match ourselves again, and this time we're in the counting arm. We want to asynchronously read up to 4 kilobytes of data from the file. Here we're waiting on an inner future again, poll read on the file. When it finishes, it will return a number, which is how many bytes were actually read into the buffer. There's a special case here. If it returns that it successfully read 0 bytes, that indicates that we're at the end of the file, which means we're actually done. We can return ready with whatever our current line count is. More likely though, for a while, we're going to have a chunk of data to process. Even though our buffer is 4 kilobytes, it wasn't necessarily filled all the way up, so we only take the number of bytes that were read. We then grab all the bytes that were new lines and count them, and add that number to the line count inside our state. Again, we're not allowed to return yet, we've got more work to do, so the match ends, we go back to the loop, we come back, we're still counting, and we'll try to take the next chunk of data. If it's already got it, we'll get to keep processing. If it's not ready, the try ready macro will take care of returning not ready and we'll get polled in the future. So this ready line is where it all ends. In normal operation, we expect to eventually get here. This implementation is now complete. Now I just need a main function to actually use it. Like before, I'll take the path as a command line argument. Then I create the future using that path and attach some printouts to show the result. Then I can spawn it on the Tokio executor and it will proceed to do the work. As you can see, this future, having constructed it this way, is now extremely clean and easy to use. So let's give that a go. Cool. So this is actually about twice as fast as the other one, and still taking maybe 2.5 times as long as WC, but it's an async task. There's always going to be some overhead. And on the bright side though, it's very self-contained, it's very easy to use, and it behaves the way a future should. Is this actually a good way to count the number of lines in a file? Probably not. But it is a good demonstration of a future that goes through multiple phases and relies on inner futures using try ready. Until next time, cheerio.